with Teddy where I left, because now you guys know how I would handle something that was uncomfortable. Mm-hmm. I came in here knowing Carson, and I was like, this is the most uncomfortable conversation ever. But I'm happy that this all happened, because I think it is like created a certain type of Big Brother credit, if you will, like where somebody's truth has been like, okay, mm-hmm. they've been faced with these problems. Mm-hmm. This is how the person will handle it. And I'm just like, just be real.
We have laid in that bed with Shanna night after night saying how we wanted to play this game with integrity and with respect.
And we actually had an alliance.
Yes.
For real.
We definitely had an alliance.
Too, even if it didn't have a name, we might have had a less organized alliance, but we had a situation that she was working with us on our side.
Did she say she had an alliance with you guys?
Me, yeah. Shanna,
she had it with you guys first.
Carson,
so the first person that she betrayed was definitely you guys by asking him to come talk to me and telling us that you weren't talking to her really, like that it was not really like.
Which is bullshit, because we've always been including her.
We've never had one meeting without Shanna, never.
So
she said she was.
She's in a loop with everything.
And the other thing that tipped me off, she was waiting for me up there.
Oh, I'm sure she was.
I need to talk to you. I said. Whatever you can tell me, you can also tell.
And I
Cynthia.
Told her when she was waiting for me when I got out of the bathroom that I'm not talking to her without you being present.
And she gave me the whole story. I said, well, let's loop in Cynthia. And that is when you have a ride or die and you have complete loyalty.
Yeah.
This person's not going to be swayed either way. Mm-hmm. So if you can talk to me, you can talk to her.
Absolutely. And I told her before she got to you that I wasn't talking to her without you. And I'm not.
Right. And when she was waiting for me up there...
Of course she was.
...seemed shady.
Yeah.
Because
she knew that I said, she wanted to get to you before I was in the conversation.
I know, but if you're not shady, you can have the conversation in front of both of us.
That's right. Especially and if you're really telling the truth, then you can have the conversation in front of everybody that's calling you a liar.
She didn't want to come down and face that. I'm not going down there. I'm not going to...
Because I was like,
Cynthia's calling
come
her
on
bluff.
Down.
She's calling her
because let me tell you something. I'm a lot of things, but I'm not a liar. And all I can stand on is my truth, okay? And if it's my truth, I can come to your face. I know exactly what I've told you. I know what I've said to you. I know what I've said to you. I know what I said to everybody. So let's all get in the room. Now, who lying? Mm-hmm. And that's what it is.
So now what?
Well, now we... Well,
do we still do the same thing?
I'm glad that she had an opportunity to explain herself, but I just don't believe that at the end of the day...
Ride with it.
I'm good.
Where's the
charge
with that?
Whatever y'all do.
There's... Yeah. There's two ways to do it.
I know you're dangerous, but I don't mind a fair fight.
Thank you. I appreciate that. That's how I felt, too.
I agree.
Same.
I don't mind a fair fight.
I really, really agree.
And you're not too shabby either.
Oh, stop biting away, Carson.